Leute, Kramix hier, was geht, Harry Paul Berger? Wir werden heute gemeinsam auf Gadgets that will you give Superpowers reagieren, also auf Deutsch übersetzt auf Gegenstände, Werkzeuge, die einem Superkräfte geben. Ich bin sehr, sehr gespannt, meine Freunde. Wir starten immer rein in 3, 2, 1. Lasst ein Like und ein Abo da und let's go mit dem Video.
More superheroes jumping off the pages of a comic book and onto the big screen. Action-packed blockbusters are awesome and all, but we keep asking ourselves, why can't I do that? Zany inventors are using their superior intellect to create all sorts of weird and wonderful gadgets that might just put some superheroes out of a job. Ready to take a look? Let's get it on.
Überlegt euch, wie krass das wäre, wenn es wirklich so einen Iron Man Anzug geben würde.
Modern science hasn't allowed us to run enough to travel through time like the Flash, but this has to be the next best thing. Who needs the Flash Force when we have the harnessed energy of an ostrich? These bionic boots have been designed to perfectly simulate the stride of the biggest flightless bird in the world. A gentle jog will have you hitting speeds of 25 miles per hour without breaking a sweat, while sprinting can see you cracking the 40 mile per hour mark. To put that into perspective, that's faster than most suburban speed limits. Mere mortals have a running stride of up to 5 feet, but thanks to some help from our feathered friends, that can be stretched out to more than 3 times the distance, to over 16 feet. This is all thanks to a design that mimics a bird's
backward-facing knee,
using springs to absorb the human's weight as potential energy before using it to explode forward quick as light.
Also ganz kurz, weil es gerade alles auf Englisch ist, das sind halt wie so Federungen quasi eingebaut und diese Boots, die man da anziehen kann, die nutzen halt einfach dein Körpergewicht, um dich immer wieder nach vorne zu pushen mäßig. Also so mäßig mit kinetischer Energie. Sehr, sehr nice. Digga, damit rennt man einfach 64 km/h. Alter. Das ist schon schnell, Digga. Das ist schon schnell.
Flyboard Air.
Also in der Stadt wird man damit schon geblitzt, so nix.
Silver Surfer is in an eternal contract of servitude to the World Eater Galactus.
Hey,
endlessly
geil, Alter.
Flying through space on his surfboard, looking for planets to serve up to his master on a silver platter. If you're an Earthling, you get all the mid-air surfing madness, minus the alien genocide, of course. During the Singapore Formula One Grand Prix, Marina Bay became the scene for a truly awesome sight. Frank Zapata was asked to pack a very special invitation into his suitcase and come showcase it for the world. We're talking about the world first jet-powered hoverboard, a contraption that he's dubbed Flyboard Air. The engines run on a mix of kerosene and jet fuel, able to propel a 220-pound human through the air at speeds in excess of 100 miles per hour, almost 500 feet above the ground. The
only cons. Alter, das sieht halt wirklich schon aus wie aus irgendeinem Superheldenfilm, wenn jemand so angeflogen kommt. Also ganz kurz, das ist quasi mit Jetdüsen sind da eingebaut. Und das Ding tankt halt auch Kerosin. Also ist auch nicht ganz ungefährlich, wenn du da drauf stehst und das Ding fackelt dir halt ab, dann bist du halt einfach am Arsch und fällst dann halt irgendwie voll tief runter. Und man kann, was meinten die gerade, 500 Meter oder 500 Fuß hoch damit fliegen? Also sehr, sehr krass und 100 Miles per Hour schnell, was dann halt, keine Ahnung, das müssten ja dann so, keine Ahnung, irgendwo 160 km/h oder so kannst du damit schnell fliegen.
That fly time is currently limited to just 6 minutes. Oh, yeah. And you're effectively strapped to a flying bomb.
Aber kann leider nur 6 Minuten fliegen und der Typ hat halt auch gesagt, man ist quasi auf einer fliegenden Bombe. Ist halt schon ungefährlich, aber natürlich krass. Sure.
Aquaman can hitch a ride by grabbing the dorsal fin of a passing orca. So what? The Sea Breacher takes everything awesome about a killer whale, then makes it better through the wonders of technology. This is a semi-submersible boat that can crack 70 miles per hour and is capable of pulling 0 to 60 miles per hour in 4 seconds flat, courtesy of a 260 horsepower supercharged power plant.
Also 110 km/h kann man damit fahren.
Leaping out of the water, then diving back underneath thanks to an ingenious snorkel system.
Wie cool ist das?
Just Free Willy who's getting
replaced
so either. The Sea Breacher Y is shaped like a dolphin, solving crime way better than Flipper ever could. Well, probably. Either way, it's super quick. Likewise, Jaws has to wait until it's safe to get back in the water, courtesy of the Sea Breacher Z, which looks like the love child between a great white shark and a fighter jet. At $80,000, all this could be yours. I'm sure Aquaman would be jealous, though.
Real-life lightsaber. Von einem
Build it and they will come. The hacksmith succeeded where others could.
Ein echtes Laserschwert kriegen wir jetzt gezeigt.
Only dream and pretty much built a lightsaber. Now we know Jedi mind tricks and Darth Vader's famous Force choke are still a far way off. But as if you don't want your very own 4,000 degree Fahrenheit plasma cutter to destroy your enemies, or at the very least cut yourself a slice of birthday cake like an absolute boss. At these temperatures, this imitation blade isn't far off the real thing. Able to melt titanium on contact. It's actually a massive superheated plasma, similar to what's used to industrially cut through solid steel plates. The only downside.
Das sieht halt Real Talk aus wie ein Laserschwert, das Ding. Und das ist ein 4000 Grad heißer Plasmastrahl. Alter, wie geil ist das? Das sieht genauso aus wie Laserschwerter. So start practicing. But also, carrying around huge oxygen and propane tanks just to get a measly 5 minutes of use tells us that there's still just a tap. Das ist halt das Problem. Man braucht halt so einen Propantank auf dem Rücken und dann hält das halt auch nur 5 Minuten. Had more research and development that has to be done before we get a proper finished product. Gravity Industries. Aber im Prinzip, wenn es irgendwie eine andere Energiequelle geben würde, wäre es möglich, Laserschwerter zu haben. Good news. Iron Man's suit is now available to buy for the rock bottom price of $602,000. The billionaire playboy has you all fooled. Es gibt einen Iron Man Anzug für $600,000. Multiple successful companies and rub shoulders with the Avengers to get what you want. Okay, das sieht scheiße aus. Das sieht ja nicht aus wie Iron Man. So worth it. The Gravity Industries jet suit weighs in at an impressive 55 miles per hour. Despite giving the pilot full flight control thanks to 5 mini-jet engines, one on the backpack and two on each hand for steering. If you're thinking it's a blatant knockoff of Iron Man's suit, then you'd be correct. A full tank of fuel is enough to support the combined total of 1,050 horsepower for a fleeting 9 minutes. Supersonic flight is still a long way off too, with the max speed of this imitation being 32 miles per hour. Sadly, no offensive weaponry, though it's rumored to be coming up in the Mark II version. Just kidding, it isn't. But being able to fly is enough to convince me. Now, where am I going to get that money from? Dr. Octopus suit. When life starts to imitate fiction, that's the time to start getting worried. Dr. Octopus has animatronic arms fused and grafted to his spinal cord, giving him 4 extra mechanical claws to climb buildings with, rob banks, and do all other manner of general bad guy stuff. Self-made millionaire Eric Finman may only be 19, but he knows a good investment when he sees it. Using his own money made jumping onto Bitcoin. Der Typ sieht aus wie der neue Spider-Man Schauspieler.
When it was still worth a pittance, he commissioned a team of engineers to make a lifelike prosthetic that could actually have some pretty awesome real-world applications for those who've lost limbs or are confined to a wheelchair. The 4 limbs are controlled using microcontrollers on each hand, with a specialized glove picking up the micro-movements and converting them to electrical signals that articulate the arms. At least someone's using their robotic arms for good instead of evil. Jetman Dubai. About the closest thing to being the Falcon has to be Jetman Dubai. Cruising through the air with rocket power, a huge pair of bright red wings, and a face shield to keep the bugs off looks about right to us. Built specifically for vertical takeoff and flight, this crazy jetpack is capable of some pretty serious speeds.
Krank, Alter.
It takes just 8 seconds
to go aus wie dieser Falcon von Avengers.
From ground level up to 300 feet. The next 300 feet is done in just 4 seconds. The next 900 feet, 5 seconds. All in all, it can shoot up to an altitude of 3,000 feet in half a minute flat at an average speed of 130 knots or 150 miles per hour. It's not far off having a NASA booster rocket strapped to your back with a theoretical max speed of 250 miles per hour, maybe faster. Not just content with straight line speed, the Jetman Dubai is able to perform barrel rolls and loop the loops that would make a stunt plane blush. Up, up and away. Skeletonics. The Arrive suit was designed by a Tokyo-based company called Skeletonics, whose singular goal is to create products that make you feel like you're a giant. Talk about small man syndrome. The Arrive suit turns its wielder into a 9-foot-tall gargantuan, able to walk around and even perform fine motor skill tasks like picking up a cup and shaking someone's hand, something that their native Godzilla could never really accomplish. He was too busy punching buildings and fighting moths. This is all thanks to a master-slave synchronization system that uses neither computers nor electricity to function.
Alter.
It utilizes physics and linkages to retain the freedom and range of human motion without the need for a cumbersome battery.
Geil. Also ganz ohne Batterien und so, das ist einfach nur durch die, ja, durch die Bewegungsenergie und so übersetzt. Voll geil.
Surfboard.
Sehr cool.
The laws of physics don't apply when it comes to the world of superheroes. Unfortunately for us, mere mortals, they do. The best we can do is look like we're defying gravity with a craft that doesn't look like it should. The e-foil is a cross between a jet ski and a surfboard, using a powered leg and hydrofoil to lift the board up out of the water, fully supporting the weight of the rider. A hand control takes care of the throttle and speed, with the rider having to use their own body weight shifting from side to side in order to steer, just like the real thing. The battery lasts an impressive 90 minutes on a full charge, skimming across the water at 25 miles per hour. At 12 grand a pop, they're out of the reach of the average avid water sports fan, with lucky owners describing the experience feeling a bit like ice skiing.
Kann man machen.
Explosion-proof suit.
Explosionssicherer Anzug. Okay, das ist auch wieder sehr spannend. But he obviously hasn't experienced a Siberian winter. Proud Russian Victoria Kolesnikova has built herself a suit so impervious that neither flame nor explosions faze her. Well, she may actually be a real-life model, and we may have made up that part about her inventing the suit, but it's only a white lie. The blast-proof activewear is available from prominent Russian tactical equipment manufacturer Rostec for the right price. Wie geht das? Weil bei einer Bombe, wenn die explodiert, ist ja nicht nur das Feuer und heiß und so, sondern auch einfach diese Energie, die einen so wegwirft und juckt das ja gar nicht, das jetzt. So now it can add bombs and flamethrowers to the list of things that don't faze it. Footage of Victoria taking a lovely stroll through a field of exploding landmines and incendiary devices has to be seen to be believed. The only evidence of her walk on the wild side were a few smudge marks on her face. And how else do you greet a beautiful woman? With flowers, of course. What a gentleman. Okay, haben die leider nicht erklärt, wie das gehen soll. Ich kann es mir auch nicht vorstellen. Ich glaube, das war irgendwie fake, das letzte Video. Aber gut, Leute, ich bin raus für heute. Ich hoffe natürlich, es hat euch gefallen. Lasst gerne ein Like und ein Abo da. Und bis dann, haut rein, Leute, euer Kramik.